Swapnil, when in doubt, play the Caro Kann. Yes.
No, actually, that's the only opening maybe I know against e4. So, okay, anyways, it's a nice opening actually. Everyone should try it.
Yeah, I was going to ask you about that opening later on, but first to the game. Where did your opponent go wrong?
No, actually, I played a new line in this advanced variation, which is scoring quite well for black recently. So it's trending right now. And yeah, so I
Which
decide
is that line?
it's e4 e6, d4 d5, e5 bishop f5, knight f3 e6, bishop e2, knight e7, castles knight g6. So usually what black players used to do is to play bishop h6, bishop h7, and then knight g6, or bishop g6 and knight f5. But this is an interesting way of playing in this structure. So black goes knight e7, knight g6 immediately. And the main thing is that, okay, it seems that the f5 bishop might come under some problem. So if white goes knight e1 with the idea of g4, then black has h5, which is a good move. So if you just take on bishop h5, then queen h4 is coming. So after h5, then black can later on play h4, and the bishop is safe on g6. So basically, black has a lot of moves in trying to develop the king side, like the f8 bishop and all. So I feel, yeah, this is an interesting attempt to play, and black is scoring quite well. So I thought maybe I just analyzed it a bit, and I thought maybe I'll give it a try.
And where did your opponent go wrong?
Okay, actually, he played the knight e1 plan, but a bit later. Maybe he first played bishop e3, knight e2, and then knight e1. Maybe he should have gone knight e1 immediately because these two moves allowed my knights to get to good square. Like my knight came on g6, the other knight came on d7, and I immediately got the f6 break. After that, I think black is already quite comfortable. And yeah, I just developed my bishop to d6 and was planning to castle out to play e5, and suddenly just played f4. Which is a very desirable move to play in that structure to get complete control on the e5 square, and then later on bring the knight from f3 to e5. But it simply fails due to a tactic which he missed completely. So after f4, I took knight into f4, and it was like a simple pawn of 4, no compensation.
Okay, so a relatively smooth victory today. How was your trip to Bodh Gaya yesterday?
It was amazing. Basically, the first half of the tournament wasn't going so well for me. And also, I've read in some of the chess books that, like, if you follow a schedule for a tournament, and then let's say the things doesn't go as planned, so maybe it's a good idea to, change the schedule somehow or do some change so that, and most of the time it works. So let's say, so at least I won today's game. So let's say still 6 more rounds to go.
And Swapnil, how happy have you been with the organization of the event in Patna over here?
Yeah, it's amazing actually. I really like the organization here. Basically, before playing nationally, I was a bit afraid because of last previous year's national premier championship, which was held in Lucknow, which was obviously very bad and a disaster. But okay, I also know that. Yeah, I also knew that ASEF will obviously do a lot better in this tournament, and obviously, I can see. I'm really enjoying playing in this venue. The Lemon Tree Hotel is superb, and I think the playing venue is really fantastic.
And one general question that we are asking everyone today goes to you as well. Suppose a person offers you an X amount to leave chess, what would that amount be for you?
I don't think so. I'm going to accept any amount in order to leave chess because basically, amount won't give you the same kind of tension, the same kind of happiness which we get, while playing chess. I mean, the tension which we experience, the excitement which we experience while playing chess, while playing a really tough game of chess, is simply not something which we can get by a lot of money, let's say some 10 crores, 20 crores. So, and also, the thing is that I don't really believe that after a certain point, if you get a lot of money, the quality of your life will improve in any way. So, I feel chess is something which I am not going to leave for anything, any amount of money or for anyone. So, basically, I really enjoy it since my childhood, and I will continue playing it.
That was a very deep thought. Thank you so much, Sophie.
Welcome.